Zombie, zombie, zombie. Everybody these days has a zombie survival plan. Mine mostly involves weeping in the fetal position in the dark, but fortunately, or unfortunately, depending on how much you've already sunk into your zombie contingency plan, a traditional undead zombie outbreak is never going to happen because zombies are physically impossible. Here are five reasons why.
Who's there?
Okay, the conditions of the zombie outbreak set in. Let's say a space probe returns from Venus, explodes in the atmosphere, and that somehow wakes up all the corpses on the planet. Doesn't really make sense to me, but Romero said it and I believe it, so imagine you're a corpse. You're just lying in your coffin, minding your own business, when suddenly you wake up with a craving for the moist savor of human flesh. Or whatever, you know. That hunger you feel, anyway, suggests that your body is still subject to the laws of physics, namely the conservation of energy. If you're gonna be walking around, chasing survivors, and moaning for all those brains and whatever, all of that activity costs your body energy. And for energy to be going out of your body, it also needs to be coming back in. Normally, this happens when a living human body converts chemical energy from food in the process we know as metabolism. But an undead creature like a zombie has essentially already declared energy bankruptcy. Obviously, corpses don't have the working digestive system and metabolism to turn food into usable energy. A dead body has no metabolism, and thus it can't really do anything. Let's say we just ignore the fundamental energy metabolism problem and we just grant that dead rotting bodies are able to walk around looking for fresh brains. We immediately run into another huge obstacle, the weather. It's easy to forget that living organisms spend a huge amount of effort protecting the insides of our bodies from the whims of the weather. Just one example, thermoregulation. Thermoregulation means being able to keep your body's internal temperature within a certain range, even if that temperature outside is a good bit higher or lower. Thermoregulation is a form of homeostasis, which just means being able to dynamically adjust variables to keep the internal conditions of your body relatively stable. Zombies, having none of these capabilities, better hope the weather's nice or it's lights out yet again. Without thermoregulation, sub-freezing temperatures would crystallize whatever moisture content is left in zombie flesh, destroying tissues, including that all-important and delicious brain tissue. So, no zombies in winter. Likewise, though, zombies in a hot, dry desert climate would quickly see their moisture evaporate, leaving them shriveled, desiccated, delicious raisin corpses. But let's say you imagine your zombie outbreak in a very hot, humid jungle climate. Everything would be fine, right? Wrong.
There! Pretty as a picture! Ah! Zombies! There! Pretty as a picture!
Here, we get to another problem. Have you ever seen what happens if you leave a piece of raw meat sitting out for a week in a hot, humid climate like you do? That's right, it's swarming with flies and smells of rot. That is, if it's still where you left it when you come back to check. Presumably, the same thing would have to happen to a zombie. Having no immune system, zombies would almost immediately become infested with microscopic opportunists like bacteria and fungi, not to mention millions of insects like beetles, flies, maggots, and other carrion-eating insects. That sounds fun. These efficient organisms can consume a given mass of dead flesh at an alarming rate. On top of that, you can count on vultures, dogs, raccoons, and other adorable large-scale scavengers to come looking for their taste as well. I mean, really, every zombie in every zombie movie should be dragging a train of scavengers, large and small, everywhere it goes until its bones are picked clean. Okay, all right, you're saying, just ignore all that. Let's imagine they can walk, moan, and eat brains in a climate-controlled, scavenger-free zombie wonderland. We've pointed out that lacking a metabolism, zombies can't turn food into usable energy. But there's another problem with the whole brain-eating impulse. If zombies lack a functioning digestive system, they probably can't poop. The brains have nowhere to go, so they would just likely pile up in the digestive tract and ferment, which would produce expanding gases, and eventually the zombie's stomach might just burst. It's disgusting. Finally, I would just like to point out that zombies would probably have a really hard time finding you. True undead zombies exist in various states of decay, and the soft tissue of the eyes would be one of the first things to disintegrate as the zombie rots. This means that most zombies, except maybe the really fresh ones, would have no vision, and thus would have a pretty difficult time chasing you down. Of course, some types of zombie mythos say that zombies hunt by smell or hearing. Those senses might not become impossible as fast as vision, but over time, the same general ideas apply. So, old school undead zombies, it's just never gonna happen. But that doesn't necessarily rule out various conditions of mass psychosis or zombie-like infections. So maybe you shouldn't scrap your zombie survival plan just yet. You just might need to adapt it to some kind of mind-stealing murder fungus scenario. Anyway, what do you think is the most scientifically plausible zombie scenario? Let us know in the comments. And if you like this video, subscribe. And of course, if you want to know more about zombie science, check out 10 Reasons Zombies Are Physically Impossible at HowStuffWorks.com.